Okay, let's add something new to our URLs called a query parameter, also known as get parameters, and we'll talk about this name shortly when we start talking about HTTP. Here is an example. We've got our normal URL, or the type of the simple URL we just discussed, with a simple path slash foo, and we've added to the end of this a question mark p equals 1. And this adds an extra parameter whose name is p and whose value is 1. The format of a query parameter looks like this. You've got name equals value, or in this case, p equals 1. And the value can be just about anything, but it's good not to use question marks and other URL characters, although you could if you really wanted. We can make this a little bit more complicated by adding more query parameters. Let's do that. We've added a second query parameter. The first query parameter is separated from the URL using a question mark. All of the following parameters are separated from each other using ampersands. The first one gets a question mark, the next one gets an ampersand. In this case, the new parameter is q, and it equals the string neat. So we have these query parameters. What are they for? They're for basically when you make a request for this path, this is extra information the server gets. And there's all sorts of things you can do with this. If this is a web application doing fancy things, these parameters might mean something. It can affect caching, because technically it changes the entire URL. So there are all sorts of handy uses that we'll discuss later in the class for what these query parameters can do. But they're separate from the path, but they are included in part of the whole URL that the server sees when you make a request. In the following URL, what is the value of the z parameter? Here is your URL.